Hello and welcome to week 11 of After Before Friday. Today I'll be showcasing two selective editing tools, the radial filter and the adjustment brush. The photo that I've selected is one that I took in Estes Park, Colorado, of a horse-drawn carriage, or more specifically, the horses drawing the carriage. And in its original form, there's nothing really all that special about the photo, but the horses were beautiful and I wanted to find a way to highlight these wonderful animals. So I started playing around, and the first thing I did, I decided less is more, and I'm going to crop the photo to just include one of the horses. So I come to my crop overlay tool and click on it to activate it, and I'm going to unlock the aspect ratio so that I have more freedom as to where I can pull in the lines. And I'm going to bring it in here, and I'm going to bring it up, and I'm cropping it to the rule of thirds. You can see the rule of thirds overlay, and I like that. The grid point is just a bit above the horse's eye, but I like where this is lying, so I'm going to leave it there. When I'm done with the crop, I click done. And there's my new composition. Now, typically the first thing I look at is the exposure and make adjustments there. However, I like the exposure on this. What I want to change is the contrast. And I like to use the tone curve to set my contrast and use the Lightroom preset on the medium contrast curve. And contrast just changes lights and darks in equal proportion, and I like the added punch that it gives when I choose the medium contrast. Because I've decided that I really want to focus on highlighting the face of the horse's head, I want to darken the other areas of the photo, and so the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go back to my basics tab, and I'm going to come to my shadow slider, and instead of opening up the shadows to expose detail, I am going to decrease the shadows, which will make the darker areas of the photo darker. If I come up to the tab up here to show shadow clipping and I clip on it, I haven't lost any detail in the black areas. If I had, let's see, if I slide the black slider, you'll see where it's blue, that means there is shadow clipping going on and I've lost detail. But just by diminishing the shadows, I have lost none. I'm also going to reduce the vibrance just a bit. I have my camera set to cloudy white balance, which tends to give warmer tones, and I'm just going to decrease it a bit in post-processing. And now, as you'll see when you look at the histogram, the colors and tonal range is spread out from left to right, and I like how the photo is looking here with that greater tonal range. I'm going to come down to the details panel and I'm going to apply some sharpening. I do have presets. I'm going to apply my sharpen JPEG preset. When I click on it, you'll see the sliders change, and that just applies some gentle contrast, which is perceived as sharpness. Now at this point, I want to move into using the selective editing tools. These tools are the adjustment brush, radial filter, and the graduated filter, and these are used to apply local adjustments. Each tool isolates pixels in unique ways, and usually you use the adjustment brush last since it's the most precise, and you'll already know what the combined effect of the other two filters are if you've used them. So the first filter that I'm going to use is actually the radial filter. I will come up here to the panel where it hover over the filter, you'll see radial filter, and I will double click on that. The radial filter creates a geometric overlay that defines the boundaries of the changes you wish to make, kind of creating a vignette-like effect. So I want to create a radial filter over the horse's head to begin with, And so I move the crosshair into the picture and I hold left side of my mouse, left click, and I drag. And as I drag and move, I can change the shape and the size of the filter. Once I let go, it gives me these anchor points that I can click on to change the shape even more. And I need to make it a little bit bigger. And I also want to rotate it because the horse's angle head is at an angle. If I come down to the anchor point, you'll see when I hover there, it changes to a double arrow, which allows me to rotate. And so I continue playing with this until I'm happy with where it's at. And you'll see that the horse's head is slightly fuzzy. And you wonder why that is. I come over here and I have not cleared out my sliders for the filter. Sharpness was set at minus 100 from a previous project. So I need to zero out all of the adjustments for the filter and before I start loading in the effects that I want. So here we go. That's all at zero. And what I want to do is I want to make the area surrounding the horse's head a bit darker. If I leave this invert mask box checked, whatever sliders, whatever effects I choose will be applied to the horse's head, whatever is inside the filter. For example, I'll show you. I will increase exposure and the horse's head will get lighter. Well, I want the area around the head to be affected. So in order to do that, I uncheck invert mask. And now whatever effects I apply, they will be applied outside of the radial filter, leaving the horse's head in the state that it is now. So I'm going to decrease the exposure, creating a vignette around the horse's head. And I decrease it just a fair bit. And you'll see that there's still no black clipping that's of any consequence, and I like it there, so I'm going to leave it there. To get out of that radial filter, I just click done. There you go. Next, I'm going to use the adjustment brush. This is for precision edits. It will allow me to paint a mask over the areas that I want to modify. And there are two areas that I want to modify. The first one is back at the horse's head. I want to increase the sharpness of the head, but I also want to blur areas around the head, kind of giving it that Gaussian blur effect, a shallow depth of field. So the first thing I'm going to do actually is I'll come over to the adjustment brush and I will left click on it. And I'm going to apply the sharpening effect to the horse's head. So once I get the crosshairs where I want it, I left click again to activate it. And as long as that circle has a black dot in the middle of it, that means this this point is active, this brush is active. I'm going to reset my sliders. I want the sharpness to be, I'm going to set it at 100. And I also want to increase the highlights, so I'm going to load the highlight slider just a bit. And as I start to paint, you should see a little bit of an effect. And actually, I'm going to stop and I'm going to show you, if you come down here and click on Show Selected Mask Overlay, you'll be able to see where I have painted. So I'm going to come up here and I'm not going to do as careful a job as I would or as I did in my initial photo, but I just want to give you the idea of how this is done. And as I get into smaller places, I can change the diameter of the brush by scrolling on my mouse wheel. If I go one direction, it makes it bigger, and if I go the other direction, it makes it smaller, which is useful when you get into smaller areas. So again, this isn't as careful an effort as I originally did, but for time constraints, I'm doing this quickly. Up here, and then when you're done, You can come back and unclick the Show Selected Overlay Mask. And then when you apply your changes, I'll show you just if I decrease the highlights, you'll see it getting darker. Again, I wanted to increase the highlights here, so you'll see that change. Sharpness, I increased the sharpness to 100. If I wanted to blur the head, decrease it here and you'll see it blur. Again, I want sharpness in the head, so these are the two effects I want for the head. And I am done at this point with this adjustment brush. However, I want to do a second one. And the second one, I'm going to use it to blur the surrounding area of the horse's head. So I'm coming back over to the adjustment brush. I'm left clicking again. I'm creating a new adjustment brush. This time I will click over in the area where I want to begin. And again, always remember to reset all your sliders before you begin your effects. And on this slider, all I want to do is decrease the sharpness. I want to blur. So I'm going to slide the sharpness slider all the way to the left. And as I begin to paint, I'm actually going to show the selected overlay by clicking down here so I can see where I'm painting. And I'm going to begin to paint. Again, I'm not doing as careful a job as I did in the photos. And what I've decided I want to do, it's kind of like a graduated filter. In essence, I'm not going to blur the neck of the horse. So I want to leave, I don't want that much of a jarring change from the head to the body of the horse. So I'm coming around. Again, I can change the size of my brush by using the wheel on my mouse. And bear with me as I continue to do this. And it's really, it's a nice effect if you haven't, you know, to create a shallower depth of field if you didn't have it to begin with. A little bit, obviously, much more painstaking than if I had done it in the camera, but this was a quick shot as the horses were just stopped at a stoplight. And actually, I wasn't thinking. I was just taking a shot as I got it. So it's nice to be able to add in this effect afterwards. Okay, not the clearest and cleanest, but you get the idea. I'm going to come down here and uncheck Show Selected Mask Overlay. And you see how it's blurred. Let me increase the sharpness so you can see the effect when it's sharp. And now I'm going to decrease the sharpness. And you'll see the nice blur over here. I may come back in and do just a little bit more in here. But other than that, I think it's pretty much where I want it. So unclick the overlay and I'm going to hit done. And lastly, and I'm going to uncheck the, I'm going to hide shadow clipping to get rid of the blue areas. Lastly, I like to apply a post-crop vignette. So I come down to the effects panel, and I do have, I do like to often use the Lightroom presets over here on the left-hand panel. Here's vignette number one, which is a slight vignette. And I'm going to go to vignette number two, which is heavier still. And I like that, and I think it really focuses in on the horse's head. So I'm going to come back and show you the before. This was the before image. And here's the after. And I like it a whole lot more. I think it's a much nicer composition and a nicer effect than the original photo. I hope you've enjoyed this week's video. Please feel free to ask any questions you may have about my process in the comments section. And to see more post-processing videos and after-before photos, visit visualventuring.com and select After Before Friday Forum in the menu. Thanks for watching.